I am not smart enough to put this presentation together. However, I am smart enough to repeat it in decent fashion, I hope. Angles and distances. Johnny's probably already talked about this. I'm sure Daryl touched on it earlier. Angles and distances. There's going to be a lot of times where you're going to find yourself not being able to close the distance on the call. But we have to, as officials out on the field, we have to actively move, as Johnny stated earlier, and we have to make sure we get the proper angles, okay? So this presentation was put together by these board members. In my personal opinion, the last one on the bottom, Julie Johnson, is one of the best clinicians. If you ever get a chance to see Julie, please take that opportunity. She is awesome. She was the lead of this group, and all five of them did a really good job, and we appreciate what they did for us. Our agenda, we're going to talk about a good angle. How do we achieve our good angle? Talk about our distances, our primary distances and our secondary. What are our visual indicators at first base? What are we actually looking for? We're going to be looking at plays at first base, specific plays, pull foot, swipe tags, things such as that nature. And then we're going to look at some plays from a different angle. What Julie and his crew did is they actually got a team together from Indiana. They got them out on a field, and they got them working, and they set up cameras. And they worked different plays from different angles so we could see exactly why one angle is better than the other. And then we'll take any questions. So what is a good angle? Anybody, what is a good angle? A good angle is whatever we need to do to keep all four elements in front of us. You'll hear me, I'll say it many times in the presentation, and you'll hear me repeat it any time I put on a clinic. Make sure you have the base, the ball, the offense, and the defense. If you don't have those four elements in front of you, if you only have three of those elements, you're not going to make an accurate call. If you only have two of those elements, you're definitely not going to make an accurate call. And of course, if you only have one, Lord help you. That's all I can say. Not only must we be able to see those four elements, but we have to understand the interaction between the elements. And what are we talking about? All right? So you got a first baseman, and you got the offense standing there at first base, coming to first base, rather. Sorry, you got your defense person ready to field the ball. We need to be able to see, did that foot come off the bag? Did that first baseman, yes, everything was good here, but then they had to come off the bag and make the tag, right? We need to be able to read and react the interaction between those four elements. If it's a force out, are they controlling the ball? Is the defense in contact with the base? Is the offense in contact with the base? The tag plays? Is the defense contacting the offense with the ball? We can't just sit there and stay in one spot and think we're going to see all the elements. We've got to be on the move. Of course, is the defense maintaining control of the ball? Are they in contact with the base? Our primary positioning, force outs at first base. We want to make sure that we first, coming off the line in the game of fast pitch, we need to make sure we get 90 degrees from the throw. Now, the slow pitch guys in the room, it's the exact same thing. And I know you're going to say, well, James, but we're all the way over here. We're off of what? The first base side of the second baseman. Folks, that's key to remember that in the slow pitch game. Because when we go out and we evaluate, and Daryl can back me up on this, and Johnny, I know you watch a lot of slow pitch, our guys have a tendency to keep cheating further over and further over and further over. Before you know it, they might as well be playing second base because they're so far over. Slow pitch guys, we realize that you're on the first base side of that second baseman. You should be able to come towards that line to achieve that 90 just as much as we want the fast pitch guys to come off that line and achieve that 90. Yeah, absolutely.
I had an umpire call me here not too long ago and ask me how can we move our umpire off the line into what they call the beast line, I guess you could say. He said, because now it makes our umpires lazy. Our slow pitch umpires. The answer is, if you're lazy, you're lazy. It doesn't matter where we put you. You choose to be lazy. So it doesn't matter where you're out on the field. If you want to be lazy, you're going to be lazy.
And the second piece of that is we want you 90 degrees to the throw, but we don't want you to exceed that 45. Now, I know we watch upper levels of ball in different conferences and whatnot, and we see those collegiate umpires, and I'm not picking on them, but we watch those games, we see them. That ball's hit right in front of the catcher. They pick up the ball. They're getting ready to throw to first base. What does the first base umpire do? They rotate all the way around and achieve a 90 here looking at first base. Now, they got the ball in front of them. They got the base in front of them. They have the offense and defense, but what are they missing? They're missing what we previously said, possibly the interaction between the elements. By over-rotating past that 45, you're going to take yourself out of the picture, and we'll show you examples of that here in just a little bit. On tag plays, we're going to have a primary position. Your primary position, just like while ago, is 90 degrees to the path of the throw. That's on a force out. Now you're 90 degrees to the path of the runner. 90 degrees to the path of the runner, just short of the base you're trying to achieve. Then, from there, now, the interaction of the elements. What do we need to do? Do we have to move to the left? Do we have to move to the right? Or is everything in front of us and we can just make our call? Distances and primary viewing angles. This is what we're going to talk about a lot, spend a lot of time on this. Folks, believe it or not, when I was umpiring, for some reason I always thought, I got to get close. I got to get my nose in there. I got to see everything. The closer you get, the less you see. Further is better. When's the last time you actually heard somebody tell you, further is better? Back up. And I'll show you why. Talking about distance in your primary viewing area, okay? Your distance at 8 foot, if I'm focused on a spot, so I'm my, Greg, raise your hand. There's my buddy Greg Charloff back there at the back of the room. If I'm focused directly on Greg, from Greg, at this distance, I can see, and accurately see, that sunshine ray right above his head. The further I back up, and I'm in a smaller room, but as I back up, now I can see above the sunshine ray, and I'm just starting to see halfway up that mirror without having to do what? Actually take my head and look up, because when you look up, what have you done? You no longer have what?
The
base, the ball, the offense, and the defense, right? You may have the defense and the ball, but you're missing the offense, correct? And the base. So, at 8 feet, roughly about 4 foot 7 is what you can see. At 10 feet, 5 foot 9. But what I'm getting at without reading them all is the further you go, the better you see. Where do we start in the game of fast pitch on the line? 18 to 21. At 18 feet, I can see 10 foot 4. 21, I can see 12 foot 1 inch. I am almost, just by taking my step off the line, yes, I'm going to walk forward, okay, but as I walk forward, I can almost just step into the diamond and be in that 18 to 21 cushion, correct? The other thing is, we talk about this, in order to keep that direct line on that bag, when you push off in the game of fast pitch into the diamond, we need to make sure that we're doing a crossover into the diamond, so that what did my eyes just do? My eyes stayed forward, and where's the ball at? It's either over here, or I need to see it over there. But if I choose to push and turn, by pushing on the wrong foot into the diamond, now what have I done? I can see Darryl good, and if the play's coming from second base, I got a good angle. I mean, I got a good view of it, but the ball's coming from anywhere else. I've now turned my back to the ball, correct? All right, so here's an example. 5'5" player. I'm playing first base, a little short stubby me at first base. I hope I can reach 7'8". If I can reach 7'8", and that throw comes to me at 12 foot from the play, what is the umpire going to miss?
Ball.
Granted, you can see the offense, correct? I mean, the defense, correct? If the runner was there, you can see the offense. She's back there, you see her. You can see the base, but what are we missing?
The ball.
The ball. Folks, I'm going to say it all day long in this presentation. The base, the ball, the offense, and the defense. You've got to have all four, and you got to keep your eyes on all four. Here we go. We're going to back up 15 feet. I backed up just 3 feet. Oh, what a world of difference it makes. Do I not now have the base, the ball, the offense, and the defense? Yes? 3 feet, folks. What a difference it makes. Trust me on that. 5'5", same reach, 18 feet. Even better, right? Now, let's change it up. Let's get somebody a little taller. I wasn't doing very good, so we're going to put Darryl out there to play first base. 6'2", 10'1" reach. 12 foot from the play. Oh my. Oh my. We can't even see your head. What are you going to have to do as an umpire to keep all four, try to find all four elements? You're going to be stationary because we want to go stop before we make our call. We're going to take our eyes up to find the ball. We don't want to take our eyes off. We want to keep everything so we see all four elements in front of us at all times. Even now, while go 15 feet was great, right? Shorter first baseman, 15 feet, I saw it all. Not now. Not now. So now I back up to 18, and now I can see everything. Folks, we have to adjust to the game. We have to know our players. We don't necessarily have to judge the talent of our players, because that's not what we're there for. But we can understand the height of the players, the speed of the players, and stuff like that, right? So we know we got a taller first baseman. In order to keep all four elements, we just simply slide back and we can keep it all in front of us. Visual indicators for alignment at first base. Earlier when we were talking about the force play at first base, we talked about 90 degrees of the path of the throw. Easy visual indicators, folks. Easy visual indicators. To obtain the proper base, F3 is going to set up for a throw, correct? F3 is going to stand. If the throw is coming from second, she's going to go just like this. If the throw is coming from shortstop, she's going to go right here. If the throw is coming from third, the throw is coming from home. Watch in just a second as we move them around. Their shoulders, let their shoulders be your guide to your 90 degree angle. Let their shoulders be your guide. You'll see right here. Ball's going to be hitting the plate to the second baseman. Oh, I'm looking at it backwards, sorry. To the shortstop. Shortstop throws over to first. They extend out across the diamond. Line up that 90 with their shoulders. See her shoulders extending that way, and then boom. You get your 90 off the back corner of that bag with her. What is the 45 degree angle first base? We've all been taught that throughout our career. How do we determine a 45 degree angle? All we do is draw a line corner to corner, right? Inside corner, outside corner, that's your 45. Draw you a line that extends. Folks, for those of you that are in here that are instructors, the best thing you can do, there's two things that I would like to suggest to you to take back to your fields when you're training younger officials. The first thing is buy those cheap little soccer cones. You buy those cheap soccer cones, you set them up in positions. You tell them, I want you to at least get here, I don't want you to go any further than here. And what is it? It's mental training, right? Practice, perfect practice makes perfect. And the other side of that, piss poor practice makes piss poor performance. Okay? So you instill it in their mind. Go here, then react. Go here, and then react. And you do that over and over. If you don't want to buy the cones, that's fine. If you have access to your field and you can have chalk, chalk that field left and right. Put all kinds of X's and O's and marks, because that's what the younger officials need. They need those visual indicators. Here's your 45-degree angle through the back corner. How do I maintain the proper distance at first base? What we have to get in the habit of doing is making sure as we come off the line that we're moving parallel. I'm guilty of this, and I know a lot of people that I've worked with are also guilty of this. We have a tendency as we come off that line and we're moving to second base to kind of cheat in. We start moving forward, especially on our steals at second base. Our steals at second base, we got a runner on first base, so we're on the first base side of the second baseman. As they take off, they're gone. What do we want to do? We're kind of sneaking a little bit behind them. You have to imagine, as Larry Montgomery said down in Houston, you have to imagine the railroad tracks. Railroad tracks has two ties running, right? They're always running parallel. Those train tracks are never crossing, correct? So as that runner leaves first base and is heading for second, you do the same thing. That same push-off comes into effect. We're pushing off, across, and we're moving parallel. Guideline for keeping your depth, if you were able to draw that line from first base to second base, which we know we don't have, but again, if you're a trainer back home, nothing wrong with putting line chalk on that ground. Boom, off that line, keeping that distance. Especially at first base, when you push into that diamond, don't scoot up. Take that step, because we're moving on the pitch. We're moving on the pitch and pushing straight in. Plays at first base when we have a throw from second. To achieve, we're already starting 18 to 21, correct? If you're in the slow pitch game, you're rotated over here. So in order to achieve that in the fast pitch game, though, it's only going to take you about a step and a half. You're only going to need to come into the diamond, barely even that 3 feet to achieve that 90 degree angle. If you're in the game of slow pitch, you got a little bit more ground to cover, yes? But it can be done, I promise you. They used to tell a little old joke about myself, as they used to say, if you ever watched me umpire, that I could move from point A to point B as if chicken, a bucket of chicken was waiting on me at point B. So if you ever see me, you say, hey, chicken! I know what you're talking about. Throw from the shortstop now, we got to move a little bit further right, we got to exceed past that 90, but not past the 45. So now we got to get 8 to 10 feet in the diamond, so it's only going to take us about 3 to 3 and a half steps. Now this is just on average. Obviously my steps are different than Daryl's, that are different than Johnny's, okay? Third base area. Now we got to go even further, so now we're going to get to that 45. Again, parallel movement across the diamond. Set up, we still need to maintain that 18 feet distance because this is just a routine force out. So we still need to keep that proper distance to keep all four elements in front of us. 15 and a half feet approximately from where you started. That's going to take you anywhere from six steps, maybe a little more, maybe one or two less. In the game of ASA softball, what we consider throws from third base, as you see in the red diamond, that's anything from first to third, directly through the pitcher's mound, all the way back to your plate. So what is that mostly encompassing? What play in the game of fast pitch is that encompassing? That's all our bunts, right? And then slow pitch, the little woo, as long as they don't chop, right? On our tag plays, it's a whole other world. Things are different. Still at second base, here we go, right? Everybody agree at this initial point of contact, the initial point, we got a good 90 on the play, yes? There it is, draw it up, good 90, everything's there. This umpire, in my judgment, can see all four elements, the base, the ball, the offense, and the defense. But what about... Extra base hit to the outfield, okay? Talking about our button hook. Fast or slow, either game, our button hook. What we must do is we must make sure as we button hook in and we get ready to make that turn, what do we have to keep in front of us? Before we can see the ball's obviously behind us. The ball went out, so by mechanic, we're coming in, right? The ball's behind us, but who can we pick up immediately in front of us? The runner. That runner's coming to first base. We plant and pivot. There's our runner. There's our bag. Now what? Pick up our ball and then read and react, okay? We can't do this. We can't come in and pivot in. If I pivot in, what did I lose? I lost the base, and I also lost my runner. So when that coach goes, time, Mr. Blue, I would like to peel in this first base. They didn't see it, you're going to give me a save, but we all know that's a cop-out because you didn't see it, right? So we need to make sure if we just rotate that other way and rotate correctly, we'll keep those elements in front of us. The other thing is what we call backing in. Backing in is when you seem to choose that you didn't get enough distance inside that diamond. So yes, you came in, yes, you planted, the elements are in front of you, but instead of stopping and keeping everything in front of you, now we have a tendency to take those one or two steps back, okay? Achieve that proper distance as you come in, then you won't have to worry about backing up. Extra base hit to the outfield, again. Same thing applies as a steal while ago, those railroad tracks, right? We're moving parallel on the outside because the ball's inside. Now we're going to move parallel on the inside because the ball's outside. So the ball's going to be hit.
Oh, yeah.
Button hook correctly, there's the railroad tracks. Now, on this first play right here, slides directly into the bag. Ball's there, the base is there, the offense and the defense is there. Come up and make a call, yes? What's our distance on tag plays?
10 feet.
Okay, good. Now, that's a perfect 90, but it's not always a perfect world, right? So here we go in the non-perfect world. We're going to come in, button hook correctly, pick our runner up. Notice now the slide is where? The outside of the bag. When the slide went to the outside of the bag, our umpire who did everything correctly now has to do what? Make that adjustment. By making that adjustment, we recreate that 90. All four elements are in front of us.
Let me play these two videos.
I don't mean to pick on professional officials. I really don't. Okay, maybe. I'll turn this up just about as loud as I can. This game actually has a double ejection. I'm gonna go past the first ejection. First ejection is because y'all are these balls and strikes. Right after, immediately after this warm-up, you'll see the next play. What I want you to pay attention to is the position of this umpire. Tag play at first base. What did the umpire do? Yes, the umpire came off the line. Yes, the umpire was at the 90. But was the 90 perfect for this play? Absolutely not. What could he have done to help him make that call? Give himself one or two steps towards the line. Now, of course, things get out of hand here. They come together. Now, credit. There was a question, right? So, game management. Darryl does a great game management presentation. They get together. What'd you see? You missed it. Okay, I'm sorry. I got it out. Of course, now comes the other coach out. As Darryl will tell you in a game management presentation, if you actually have a situation where you have to change that call, please tell the other coach why you're doing it. Because if you don't, you'll totally avoid this situation. But again, that's just one example. One example of how if you made one adjustment, it would help your call. And now they're going to go up on the office. Here's another situation here.
But it's the proper thing to want. Yeah. He missed.
I got it open twice. So I'll just
that's what you should have done. You would all that grief and heart. Right? Right? In that play where the speak up.
6 hours, and because of you, the call that ends it all was wrong. Here's Jim Mayfield's after Josh Elliott.
It was an umpire. Folks, I said earlier, if I ever make the Diane Sawyer for my softball career, I'm just retired. Now watch, the umpire is where? Basically, 180 degrees in a deadline to the play. The umpire is also doing what? Because the umpire didn't achieve the proper distance.
He's leaning around.
But he's moving, he's leaning, there's a lot of things, right? If you don't recognize this umpire, I'll help you real quick.
Oh, the umpire or the referee?
What is the referee?
I'll help you.
No, that's not Red Cat's one.
Anybody remember this? Again, another situation. Now, granted, I don't change professional baseball. I don't train professional baseball officials. But look what the first movement of that base official is. Where is he already moving? He's already moving in. He's already going to take that base out of his line of sight, correct? So, he is...
Over here.
Way
away from the base.
Oh, fancy. Our umpire is out over here, correct? There's no way that he's going to be able to keep. He's going to see the ball, because that's right in front of him, correct? He's going to see the offense for a short period of time. He can see the defense, and I give it to him, he's going to see the bag. But when we play it, you can't tell me the way this play takes place so quickly that he can see the offense actually make contact with the base.
To go, when it game last June. It cost Detroit pitcher Armando Galarraga a perfect game and a place in history. Joyce, like Neal's today, was left to make peace with his gaffe, though Galarraga's forgiveness largely spared Joyce public flogging.
Man, do the right thing.
And while certitude is the goal, it's also rather undramatic. As we saw last night, it's the rare times when the boys in blue.
Right there. The play we just saw earlier that started the presentation. Look at this line of sight.
Or he's doing that, he's just
in that.
Look at his line of sight.
He's a good accolade, right? I mean, you know, he should have seen it.
But what about, we talked about getting to that position, and we talk about rotating to a secondary, getting the all four angles, right? What if this particular umpire, the tag's going to where? Down straight on the plate. What if he takes two steps that way? And now his angle, instead of being 180, moves over, maybe a 45, maybe even a little further, and possibly set up that 90, okay? Yes, Tom.
Why wouldn't you go close to third? Come this way, close to third.
But if you come to third, what are you going to do?
Okay.
Just a second. Let's honor his question. So he wants to come this way.
Come this way about 3 feet. He might be blocked from the catcher. The catcher may have blocked it.
The catcher could possibly block it. Now, I'm not saying where the actual perfect position is on this.
Right.
I will give you, yes, you could probably, depending on the interaction of the elements, you could probably come this way as well. Okay?
Let me go back to the
So, as I told you earlier, Julie and that crew, they got together and they got the team together, got them all on the field, and they did a lot of work for us to get views from different angles. All right, so you'll see here, fast pitch game, the umpire's on the line. You got an A position and a B position. The calling positions are actually, they're not a position in this situation. They were merely a position in the cameras, okay? So we're going to start with A. In position A, I come off the line. I push into the diamond correctly. I have a 90. I can see the base. I can see the offense. I can see the defense. But I'm 100% sure on that softball. Possibly because you can see the yellow inside that black webbing, right?
Right.
Okay, but what if I just went two clicks, two more steps? Now can you see everything? It's a game of angles, folks. All I did was take another step, step and a half, and now I can see what? That foot. I don't see it too clearly here, do I? Because the foot's at the front corner. But if I change my angle, I can see the foot, the bag, so I got the base, there's the ball, there's my offense, and there's my defense. All four elements of that game are in front of me. Correct?
Oh, wait. All right, back up one slide.
Back up one slide.
You said that angle was what?
This angle is dead on 90 degrees. All I did was step off the line.
90 degrees from where?
90 degrees from that bag right now. Because look where remember we talked about the shoulders?
Hold on.
Okay.
I got you.
Okay, well let me just get it. I won't get a visual.
I just want to know where your 90 degree angle is from.
Remember, use that shoulder.
The throw.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm thinking of. Okay. Wait.
So there we go. We slid over. All the elements are in front of us. Throw came from third. There's the answer to your question.
I knew where it's coming from. You said it at the top.
That's coming in a beast.
Throw from the shortstop, pull the foot off the bag. Three cameras. Camera C, now we talked about the throw from the shortstop. We want to come off the line, we don't want to get past the 45, yes? So, ASC camera is one step off the line. B, you'll see in a minute, is about where you need to be. C, A camera would be if we over. We went over. Okay, so we went too far past the 45. Can we see clearly through that tag? This is a tag play. Remember, that's different when we talk about force plays. The tag plays, we want to look through the actual tag. If you're tagging him, reach over there and tag him. I want to look right through that tag. I don't want to be standing over here, and then he goes a tag, and I'm not really sure. I want to look straight through that tag. So here we go. We went past the 45. You can see the offense and the defense. Are you sure that that tag was applied?
No. Now it is.
Are you sure that tag was applied?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to throw one more at you. Come on. Don't do me wrong. One, two, there's three. What did I do, right? So I came off the line, throw was coming from shortstop, I went towards the 45, I didn't. Now the tag's going to the foul side of the bag. What was my movement? Back to the foul line. I go back to the foul line, oh, what a difference that makes. Especially from that angle. Not bad, excellent. Agreed? Alright. Views for throws from second base. A position, A camera setup. A lot of umpires, for some reason, sometimes believe the throw is coming from second base. I need to get out of the way of the second baseman. So if I need to get out of the way of the person to my right, where am I going to go? To the left. Folks, there is very few occasions where we're going to go into foul territory. Yes? So we got camera A remains in foul territory. Camera C comes off the line, achieves the 90 degree view path of the throw. And then again, camera B pushes that limit. All right, so here's that throw from second base as viewed from camera A. This is like, whoops, I don't want to come over here because I don't want to hit my second baseman, so I better go foul. I don't know about you, but I barely can see my defensive player. So I definitely don't have the four elements in front of me. Let's move over a little further, the B.
Pull foot.
Possible pull foot, we're not sure. But it was muddy, so maybe we'll give her the benefit of the doubt. But now do we see the offense, the defense, the base, and the ball? No. Yes.
Hold.
I'll give it to you.
Her cleat section.
Her cleat section. I know y'all are going to tell me, James, that's another professional baseball game. I don't like to watch professional baseball. Folks, when you become a trainer, and you don't have to become a trainer, when you're sitting at your home and you're watching a game, what are we all doing? We try to watch the game. But we end up watching the officials, right? This throw came from the shortstop. The umpire's line of vision is where? Straight through that first baseman's thigh. That umpire cannot come anywhere near seeing the bat. The only thing he has is the defense and the ball. I don't think he can see that bag. Yes, he can see the offense, but can he see that offense actually make contact with that bag? Not with his line of sight looking right through that thigh.
That's a bad
throw. Pull foot, he's clearly off the base. What if he would have just taken the time after rotating, realized, I need to readjust. I need to move from my primary position to a better secondary position to make sure I keep all the elements in front of me. Pick off the second base. Now this slide is generated, you have to imagine this is three man. Because if we had a runner at second in a game of fast pitch, where would we be? On the other side. So three man for fast pitch, two man for slow pitch. Because we will have some times where that catcher will catch that guy sneaking off second base sleeping and try to fire back if in your leagues you have slow pitch with Steeler. But of course we do in championship play. Camera A. I have no clue what's happening in that play. Somebody got dirty. Camera B. Maybe. But can you definitely tell where that offensive player's hand's at? How about what people think we should do. How about if we took one more step this way? If we took one more step, would we not be able to see all the way through that plate?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Pickoffs at third base, three different cameras. No code. Camera A, we can't see anything. Camera B, possibly. But remember, I talked about seeing through this tag, right? So my body is currently right here. This is what I'm looking at, right? I'm looking from here through that play. If I want to see through that tag, what if I was right there? Right there. So what does this mean if you're in three-man? You've got a runner on second base, and you're positioning in three-man, right? We're in foul territory on the line. We're in our set position. To achieve this position, what would that umpire have done? Stand up. Merely just come from the set position, stand up, and the whole world's right there in front of him. If it was a game where we were doing two-man, granted, the umpire, this is probably the angle that I would imagine, what do you say, Darryl? Maybe 75% of the time, fast pitch umpire will see this angle of two-man. Again, go back to your parallel movement, those two railroad tracks. If I'm set up here, and third base is right over there by the projector, I don't want that first move on that pickoff to be at third. I don't want that first move to be in and towards. I want that first move to be parallel. By moving parallel, I'm going to be able to achieve even from my positioning. I should at least be able to get there. It's a beautiful world if I can get here. And while we're on the topic of positioning in the fast pitch game with the runner on second base, I understand that there's going to be a runner going to third base at some point. Correct? But remember, by the book, we're supposed to be on the runner side of the fielder, yes?
Yes, sir.
So we should be on the second base side of the shortstop. How many of you, and you don't have to raise your hand, but how many of us in the room, if you want to be honest, cheat towards third base? Remember. Because, yes, I understand, again, like I said a while ago, I understand at some point that runner from second is probably going to advance to third and we might have to make that call. But at that same time, what's happening on the backside of us? A play possibly at first base. So if we get too far and we cheat towards third base, we've taken not only now do we have a greater distance to that call over there at first base, but we also now have changed our angle. Because by staying put, I could look straight at first base versus cheating towards third, and I have to do what? I'm further and I have a bad angle, okay? Folks, that's the end of my presentation for today. I hope you learned something. These ladies are phenomenal. Let me tell you one last side note on this story. When these girls took the field to do this for us, for ASA, when they took the field to do this for us, it was about 62 degrees outside and the sunshine was up. You can tell by the field conditions, the first thing that happened was the rain.